Hello, friends. Welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're doing well. We have three interesting updates for you today. As usual, let's start with SpaceX. An ex-NASA astronaut, Michael Lopez Alegria, now working for Axiom Space, said that SpaceX's first private astronaut launch will reuse the same Crew Dragon spacecraft, now engaged with NASA's Crew 1, carrying four astronauts to the International Space Station mission in orbit. The Crew Dragon spacecraft used in Crew 1 is performing a little flawless than those spacecrafts used in soaring Demo 1 and Demo 2 test flights. The Crew Dragon capsule used in Demo 1 mission is presently scheduled to launch for a second time within March 31, 2021 on the SpaceX's Crew 2 mission. Crew 2 mission will carry other group of four astronauts to the International Space Station. Crew 2, on successfully completing the mission, will be the first commercial astronaut launch in history to reuse both the rocket booster and the spacecraft. SpaceX's future missions will also include Axiom Space's first private AX-1 astronaut launch. This mission is currently scheduled to launch at the end of 2021. AX-1 will be commanded by Michael Lopez Alegria and will carry three other private astronauts, which comprises of Israeli multimillionaire Eitan Stibbe. SpaceX will therefore get the opportunity to launch Israel's second astronaut after Ilan Ramon, one of the astronauts of NASA's space shuttle Columbia. Till now, a crewed U.S. spacecraft had been holding the record of spending 84 days in orbit. SpaceX secured the second place record after NASA with Crew Dragon's 63-day spending in orbit, Demo 2 astronaut launch debut, which was completed with a successful re-entry and splashdown in the first week of August. SpaceX's ongoing crewed mission, Crew 1, is expected to spend 180 days in orbit, which is more than double the previous U.S. record and almost triple of SpaceX's own record. After completion of the 180-day period, Crew Dragon C207 will undock from the International Space Station and then re-enter in Earth's atmosphere. By almost the middle of 2021, it will splash down either in the Gulf of Mexico or in the Atlantic Ocean. When Crew Dragon C207 splashes down, its four astronaut passengers will be carefully rescued, and subsequently, the inspection and refurbishment of the capsule will start. Crew 1 will be the second Crew Dragon spacecraft to be renewed after an orbital mission. Let's move to our next news. Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, tweeted, "On November 27th at 1:49 UTC, the Indian Kartosat 2F satellite, weighing over 700 kilograms, dangerously approached the Russian Canopus 5 spacecraft. The minimum distance between the Russian and foreign Indian satellites was 224 meters. Both spacecraft are designed for Earth's remote sensing. It's necessary to maintain a distance of about 1,000 meters or more between two satellites to avoid collision. But in this incident, the two satellites, one of India and another one of Russia, comes as close as a few meters apart, which is really very dangerous. In this type of incidents, generally one of the owners of two satellites starts changing orbital path of its satellite many days before to avoid collision. However, the process of changing orbital path is very complicated. When the satellite is used for tactical purpose, then it's necessary to remain on a particular place for adequate monitoring. Changing the orbital path would hamper the tactical monitoring." Roscosmos has stated that in this situation that both satellites are remote sensing ones, which means that in all situations used for tactical purposes and remain to be in one place. The space community has been divided over the prediction models for tracking satellites in orbit. There are differences between the calculations made using each model. The existing models are the American model, European model, Russian model, while the Indian model is improving with rapid strides. Both the countries, India and Russia, have made the remote sensing satellites according to their own models. In this instance, these satellites made by using the models have not come to the expectations. Both the models went a little wrong, and the satellites got closer than the prediction showed. For the last few decades, the congestion in outer space is rising rapidly, increasing the chances of collision of satellites with one another. These satellites vary in size, from small to large, according to their functionalities. Those satellites, sent by different countries, is creating a satellite web outside Earth. Mainly, low Earth orbit is the most congested part in the outer space. The number of satellites is so increased that it's extremely necessary to control each satellite several times in a month. Let's move on to our last news. On the first day of December, Chang 5 lander started landing procedures at 9:58 a.m. Eastern Time, and then successfully touched the soil of the moon near Mons Rümker in Ocean of Storms, Oceanus Procellarum, at 10:11 a.m. Eastern Time. The lander will start collecting samples after a couple of hours by penetrating up to 2 meters in the lunar regolith. After drilling, a scoop will be used to procure lunar samples from the moon's surface. After a couple of days, a small spacecraft placed on the lander will lift off with the lunar sample. A lunar orbiter in the offing will collect the samples from the small spacecraft. By around the 16th of December 2020, the lunar orbiter will come back to the Earth with regolith samples. The Chang 5 spacecraft, which was launched aboard a Long March 5 rocket on the 23rd of November, completed a 112-hour journey to the moon and entered the lunar orbit on the 28th of November. The Chang 5 lander has 2 days to carry out its research and sample collecting processes and preparing the small spacecraft for launch. For the first 20 hours, about 2 kilograms of regolith samples will be collected. Out of this 2-kilogram sample, 500 grams will be taken while drilling, and the remaining 1,500 grams will be scooped out of the surface of the moon. These samples will be stored in a container inside the small aircraft. Congratulations to China on successfully landing of Chang 5. This is no easy task. When the samples collected on the moon are returned to Earth, we hope everyone will benefit from being able to study this precious cargo that could advance the international science community, tweeted Thomas Zurbuchen, NASA Associate Administrator for Science, on the 1st of December. After the U.S. Apollo and Soviet Luna missions in the 1970s, China's mission is the first lunar sample return mission in 2020. Dr. Lin Yang Ting of Institute of Geology and Geophysics in Beijing said that the New Age data, we can calibrate the crater counting method, being more precise for young events. Additionally, scientists will conduct compositional, mineralogical, and radioisotope analysis to find out the nature of the young basalt and its mantle reservoir. The Chang 5 lander radar and imaging spectrometer instruments will give important geological information about the lunar regolith. It will make easier to reveal the subsurface nature of the landing site, for example, revealing the thickness of underlying soil and lava flows, and also the compositional diversity of the area, said Catherine Joy, a reader in Earth Sciences at the University of Manchester. Professor Bradley Joliffe of Earth and Planetary Sciences at Washington University in St. Louis said that remote sensing is showing large concentrations of radioactive elements like thorium, uranium, and potassium in the landing area of Chang 5. He also said, these are radiogenic heat-producing elements and may help us to understand why volcanism was so prolonged and extensive in the western Oceanus Procellarum region. The Chinese Space Agency has demonstrated its capabilities several times now, and they've stayed on schedule with their ambitious plans for the past decade. They'll probably do likewise with their manned exploration. I think we should cooperate in terms of the science. It's a great way to do diplomacy. An orbiting service module is waiting in the lunar orbit and prepared to receive the samples. The small spacecraft, weighing about 500 kilograms, will be launched from the lander after collecting lunar samples. This spacecraft will be sent into a 15 kilometer by 185 kilometer orbit to dock with the orbiting service module after 48 hours. Both the orbiting module and the small spacecraft will have 3.5-hour time slot to execute rendezvous and docking operations. After successful docking with the orbiting module, the sample container will be transferred from the small spacecraft to the re-entry module attached to the orbital module. After discarding the small spacecraft, service module will wait for a week in lunar orbit, seeking the appropriate opportunity to return to Earth. The vehicle will re-enter after another journey of 112 hours from the moon to the Earth and land at Sisiwang Banner in Inner Mongolia. China has previously conducted rendezvous and docking operations in low Earth orbit using Shenzhou crewed spacecraft. Tianong Space Labs and Tianzhou cargo vessels controlling automatically and manually. This docking of spacecraft with orbiting module will be the first robotic docking operation in lunar orbit. About 5,000 kilometers above Earth, re-entry vehicle will get separated from the service module. Re-entry will include bouncing operations in the atmosphere to cope with the high speed of vehicle returning from the moon. European Space Agency's tracking stations will help during this re-entry phase. If Chang 5 succeeds in returning to Earth with lunar samples, then Chang 6 will be sent to the moon in about 2023. Chang 6 will be a backup version of Chang 5 if it fails. China has stated that after Chang 6 mission, they'll focus on a comprehensive stage of lunar exploration, which will include Chang 7 and upcoming lunar landing missions. China's aim will be to set up an International Lunar Research Station within 2030. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.